A new crew at the space station, some science on the next SpaceX resupply mission, and testing Orion's parachutes. A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA.
Steady as she goes, the Soyuz spacecraft continuing its fly around of the International Space Station.
Our astronauts Drew Feustel and Ricky Arnold and Russia's Oleg Artemyev arrived safely at the International Space Station on March 23rd after a successful launch 2 days earlier from the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan. The Expedition 5556 crew will work on hundreds of experiments during their five-month stay on the orbiting microgravity laboratory. The next SpaceX resupply mission to the space station is set to launch April 2nd from Cape Canaveral Air Force Station in Florida. Included in the 5,800 pounds of crew supplies, hardware, and research is an Earth observatory that will study severe thunderstorms and their role in Earth's atmosphere and climate, an investigation on bone marrow that could benefit future space explorers as well as humans on Earth, and a study on the production of high-performance products from metal powders, which could lead to improved manufacturing techniques. NASA successfully tested the Orion spacecraft's parachute system on March 16th at the U.S. Army Proving Ground in Yuma, Arizona. It was the first time engineers intentionally failed one of the system's three forward bay cover parachutes. The forward bay cover protects the upper part of Orion throughout its mission, but must be jettisoned during landing so the rest of Orion's parachutes can deploy. A team of engineers at our Marshall Space Flight Center in Huntsville, Alabama, have developed and tested a new 3D printing technique that can greatly reduce the cost and time needed to make rocket engine nozzles. This new technology could reduce manufacturing time from several months to several weeks and is now being licensed and considered in commercial applications across the industry. Spacecraft AR is a new mobile app produced by our Jet Propulsion Laboratory in collaboration with Google that uses the latest augmented reality technology to put virtual 3D models of NASA's robotic spacecraft into any environment with a flat surface. The initial version of the app is available for Android devices with plans to add other devices in the future. That's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at nasa.gov/twine.